So it's so important that these patients have a capacity to cultivate meaning. This enormous body of literature points that the lack of meaning at the end of life is the source of so much despair. And it's we're limited in our attempts to help patients create meaning as best we try with the various psychotherapies. Some are very helpful, but it's a very difficult thing to do for a patient. Whereas this study provides actual experience. There's a great quote by Joseph Campbell, the famous mythologist, where he says, "I don't need faith, I have experience. Experience itself can transform versus just the faith or the belief or the conversations." Some patients will come to this study with prior spiritual traditions and beliefs, and some don't. It's not a prerequisite. This study can be discussed in a secular way or in a spiritual way. It can be defined as a mystical experience known throughout history from many traditions. It brings about various religious markers, but it can be discussed as in a pretty scientific way. It's a medication that, you know, a serotonin agonist that brings about a state of consciousness where one feels unity and transcendence and interconnectedness. So it can be discussed both ways. And having a religious prior history is not a prerequisite for the study. This patient who we saw reports no prior religious history, although she's very spiritual in herself and in the way she approaches life. But it certainly isn't a requirement. It's important to know each team is a man and a woman, each session guides, so it provides a bit of a balance. So the patient may at some point may want to speak with a woman during his or her experience, or a male, and so there's the nice balance of each session guide team as both male and female.